Let's do this. Threaten that top spot. They're probably gonna take it, but that's fine. Yeah. I was hoping I would draw something a little bit better. I think I have to do this, unfortunately. And then I can use Ignalisk to take the bottom, because probably, yeah, they're gonna play there, and that's gonna... Yeah, yeah, yeah. Plus 10. When you win the lane, receive a score. Oh, Chocobo Jockey. That's not the same one that I added, but it's very similar. But now I get to take that. Hopefully you don't have any replaces. Ah, it's got a replace card. Dang, that sucks. Oh, it's the Griffin, too. Of course, because you're the Griffin person. I want the Griffin. Give me the Griffin. Another replace card. Dang. Another Griffin. Dang it. Oh, but you placed it like an idiot. All right, well, I appreciate you being stupid. That means a lot to me, personally. Okay, I'd love to draw a Freet here. That also works. Also a good draw. And then a Freed! He's a gamer! Chat, it's just too easy. It's too easy, chat. I'm unstoppable. Give me that bonus 10. What was my highest score? I got like 63 one time, didn't I, chat? We had like a wild one. Replace an ally and raise the power of allied cards on affected tiles by the replaced one's power. That sounds awesome.
Whoa. This is the first time I've ever seen Oscar lose. Didn't expect that. Seems like he's a little bitter. Anyway, thanks so much for indulging him. He can make it a lot harder for us to do our jobs when he's in a mood. Really? Believe it or not, he's gonna make his television debut soon.
Against Rolf.
He'll be up against a dog that plays Queen's Blood.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And we have to make sure he wins to help drive up tourism here. He'll pull it off.
I really don't think tourism is going to be driven up that much by a bird that can play a card game, but I mean, like, that's the kind of thing that will get, like, millions of views on YouTube. I don't think it's the kind of thing that are going to get people to, like, buy a plane ticket, though. Maybe that's just me. Right, we're here to do a side quest. I want to clean up, like, all of the game, all the area intel and all the side quests now, chat. And then after we've done that, we can go full focus on the story, presumably, until the game gives us more side quests or whatnot to do. Bow, bow, bow. By the way, I did see earlier in chat, but I think it was during all the cutscene stuff, about Baldur's Gate 3 as a potential playthrough. I'll just be real with you. The only way I would do Baldur's Gate 3 on the channel is if it was like a sub goal or something. I don't really have any interest in the game myself. So, I basically am saying I wouldn't count on it.
Telling us what you're doing. Cut it out!
Stop flashbanging my bro!
I've died and gone to heaven.
Reasonable reaction upon seeing Cloud.
That's gonna cost you $2,000.
$2,000? Although, for a visage of such pulchritude.
Chat, what does that word mean?
If I had the money, I'd pay your price in a heartbeat. But alas.
I'll pay you if you rein it in.
Don't think I caught your name.
Oh, my sincerest apologies. I'm Neve, and I write children's books for a living. Which sounds fun, but it's not, since right now I'm flat broke. I spent my last remaining gil to come scout out this village. I was hoping to use something here in my next book, but... of failure stalks me, looming from behind every corner. Will my creative instincts ever return, or am I doomed to chase them like a rat in a life-size maze?
Wait, what did you say? And that sounded a lot like... I'm a rat trapped in a life-size maze! Sorry, but I just gotta ask. You're Mead Mabel, aren't you? Author of Life in the Endless Maze. That's my daughter's favorite book in the whole world. Can I get an autograph? Wait, actually, can I shake your hand?
Of course! Anything for a fan. I mean, I always assumed I didn't have any, but it's an incredible honor to finally meet an aficionado of my work.
Barret's hand is the size of her head.
You said you were scouting this village for book ideas, yeah? If it's all right with you, we'd love to help. Got the perfect guy to serve as inspiration, too.
What?
You are perfect!
I am?
Yes, I can see it now. A warrior beast with fur as fiery as his burning soul! Curse this feeble frame! My mind races, yet my hands plod along as if trapped in treacle!
Miss Mabel, are you all right?
Resolve, suffering, odyssey. Help me to express these themes by taking pictures which embody them. I beseech you.
Resolve, suffering, and odyssey. Those are great themes. We're gonna need locations to do them justice, though. There's a riverbed by the edge of the forest that'll work. Come on, let's hit it up.
I can't wait to see your photos. They're sure to help me write a story like no other.
I should have known we'd get a picture-taking side quest at some point. I love when Barret enters dad mode so much. I love Barret and Cloud's bromance just when they're like they're just being funny together. Oh man, that was great. I loved that a lot. Oh man. Such a good game. I think I'm going to go all the way over here, by the way. Which one of the... I was about to say, how do I fast travel here? Cass, what do you like about JRPGs over Western RPGs? JRPGs are normally just better games? I don't know how else to answer that question. I mean, like... What are specific examples of a Western RPG? I like games that have, first of all, like good gameplay mechanics, obviously, but that like have interesting characters and good story is the main thing, and JRPGs just happen to have an abundance of good characters and good story because JRPGs are basically anime. Because like I really like God of War and Horizon Zero Dawn and Horizon Forbidden West. Those aren't Japanese, to my knowledge. They're not JRPGs, but they,
Green forests are great and all,
but they have great characters and, like, great story and fun gameplay. So, like... Mass Effect is Western... Okay, you don't have to tell me that Persona is a JRPG, I know that. So Mass Effect is a Western RPG. Okay, what makes Mass Effect different from Horizon Zero Dawn. Horizon Zero Dawn is like an open world game, so it just doesn't count. Does it count as a Western RPG? Is Horizon Zero Dawn a Western RPG? Or is a Western RPG something even more, is that a more specific genre? I honestly just don't know the difference. Western RPGs are more of make your own character? So Xenoblade Chronicles X, my favorite Western RPG. Witcher and Horizon are Western RPGs as well. If Horizon Zero Dawn is a WRPG, a Western RPG, then I love that game. That's like one of my 10, like probably my, Forbidden West is probably my top 10 favorite games. Maybe, top 10? Probably still top 10. Top 20 at least. I haven't really sat down and worked that out. But if the game is good, if it has a good story and narrative and characters and also happens to have some good gameplay on top, then I like that game. It just so happens that JRPGs normally fill that niche more than any other franchise for me. Especially, JRPGs typically just have an even deeper focus on characters and story than a lot of Western games, I feel like. Because, again, they're very anime-like, and that's what I love. Hello.
There you are.
Need that radio.
Thing's practically an antique.
Even better.
I cannot wait for more Sid and Vincent in the third game. I hope we get them as playable characters. Yep, chapter 12 done. I didn't realize I was starting the main mission, by the way.
Okay, give me a read back.
7, 205, 246.
Confirmed. Those are the correct coordinates. See you up north.
Roger.
All units have been apprised of the temple's location.
Good.
So, I did some digging. This keystone curse stuff, it sounds like it might be the real deal. Everyone who's ever used it has ended up dead.
Close. To be precise, those who enter the temple are never seen again. Vanished doesn't mean dead.
And that's better how? Either way, the president's sending us to our deaths. Isn't that messed up?
He'll be on site.
I'm sorry. What?
And you're surprised why?
Brano is back!
I don't know. Maybe because it's a terrible idea? Although, that's kinda on brand for him.
His vacation ended!
Wheels up. We'll arrive first and roll out the welcome mat.
Understood.
I want to see some sick cutscenes with Reno doing lightning nonsense like in Remake again, please.
Got them. They're headed for the northern continent.
North, huh? Tricky.
Can you get there?
Can I get there? Only with one arm tied behind my back. Girl might be missing her wings, but long as you got me, it'll be smooth sailing.
Oh man, this is gonna be rough.
What can I say? Life is full of ups and downs.
They've mobilized the Turks and the military. Hope you're ready for a fight.
Chat distracted me with talk about RPG definitions, and then I accidentally started the main mission. Oh wait, can I just like not? Hold triangle. Why?
This is your captain speaking. Outside your windows, you'll see open waters. Be advised, there may be sudden ocean swells. How was that?
Just kill me now.
This thing's practically a paddle boat. She could swallow us whole on a whim. So we're sticking to the shallow.
Can I not? Okay, we have to go like super up north. I didn't mean to zoom in on the grasslands there. I was trying to zoom back in on the Meridian Ocean. So we have to like go all the way up here? I think we can just, Oh, hold triangle was to dock at Gunganga. Ah, I see. I think if we just don't try and go up this northern path, we're probably fine. Because I don't want to continue chapter 13, or start chapter 13 really right now. I would like to get region intel done and whatnot. Can I actually just like fast travel out of... Wait, zoom back out. Can I just fast travel somewhere like right now? Where did I need to go for this side quest about the picture taking? Okay, you know what? Take me back to Cosmo Canyon. If I can. Okay, we're good, we're good. We're gonna hold off on the main story. I'm actually kind of glad I did that by mistake. Because now we know Reno is back. I was wondering if they were actually just going to leave Reno out for this game so they wouldn't have to like pay his voice actor or anything, and then bring Reno back in the third game. I am excited. Oh, right. I got confused last time on how to do these side quests, and I still don't know how to do them. That's going to be a little annoying. But we can mess with it next time. Oh, we get to do more Gears and Gambits, which I remember being fun. I think I would say Western RPGs tend to be more along the lines of realistic art style with huge open world, and JRPG seems to have large areas to explore and a more anime art style. I mean, a JRPG is, you know, a Japanese role-playing game. It comes from, like, a Japanese company. And as a result, is typically, like, anime-styled, etc. Because, I mean, Final Fantasy VII Rebirth right now, what we're playing? this is a pretty real, like, super realistic looking game. I mean, obviously I'm riding a chocobo right now, which is not a realistic creature. But, like, it looks realistic. It looks really realistic, but it's a JRPG for sure. We are gonna need a bigger boat, you're right. Alright, let's see if we can go get this lifespring. I accidentally ran into a thing. I would love to be done with Cosmo Canyon, because as soon as we teleported back here and I saw the, what chocobo I was on, I remembered that I hate Cosmo Canyon, and it is probably my least favorite area in the game.
Try to die now. Let's finish this.
Where you at? Hey, leave my girl alone. Is Tifa my girlfriend now? We kissed on the, well, I say we, I mean her and Cloud. I'm playing as Cloud, so you know what I mean. Her and Cloud kissed on the, whatchamacallit, Null? They dating? I think they're dating now, in my headcanon at least. I mean, I'm sure it depends on what character you got, so I don't know how it works with the canon. They're probably gonna ignore it going into third game, if I had to imagine. But I guess we'll see when the third game comes out. Where am I going? I hate Cosmo Canyon. This is definitely my least favorite area in the game. Mostly because the gliding is so boring. It's so much better in it's so much better in Nibelheim. Nibelheim actually feels like legit gliding, which is way more fun. Where the heck am I going? You haven't done anything with the pirate map. We'll probably look at doing that soon, too. Do I need to glide up there? It's so annoying not being able to tell. This was so much easier in Gonganga, where it was like, oh, where am I supposed to go, like, for this section in Gonganga? Oh, you probably just need to, You probably just need to find a mushroom nearby, and then you find the mushroom and you're like, yep, that bum bum bum, you're right there. In here it's like, hey, there are like 87 different glide points, I hope you find the right one, because you gotta glide to wherever you're trying to get to. I think I need to be on that higher up spot right there. Maybe can you not jump down from here? Okay, thank you. Come on, can you seriously not jump down right here? I hate Cosmo Canyon. This is the worst area in this game. Without a doubt. Where am I trying to get to? There and then fly there? I need to get, like, directly above where I am right now, but I don't know where I have to go to do that. You just saw the owl, which leads you to the Lifespring? Incorrect. You just saw the owl on screen that leads me to the Lifespring. I saw no such thing, good sir. How dare you lie to me like that on the internet? Can I just land right here, please? I hate Cosmo Canyon. The gliding is so slow and boring. How could they make gliding boring? It makes no sense, because gliding in Nibelheim, which they don't even call gliding because it's not the same thing, gliding in Nibelheim is so good and fun. It just sucks here. Is there a way up from, like, right here that I missed? Why does this little outcropping exist? Hello, owl. Okay, yeah, wait, there is a little cave here that I missed. Thank goodness. Now we're talking. Hello. Like, chat, I'm not insane, right? The gliding sucks in Cosmo Canyon. It's, like, so slow and boring. But then in Nibelheim, the water jet thing, and I don't just mean when you're, like, shooting yourself straight up into the air with the water jet, I also mean when you let go of the water jet and then you, like, do the fast dash down, like, that's fun gliding. It's fast-paced and enjoyable, and you can get around a lot. In Cosmo Canyon, it's super boring and slow.
A vicious dragon seems to have awakened in the Cosmo Canyon region.
Ooh.
You must slay it, ere the ferric earth is dyed an even darker red.
We get to fight a dragon? The wyvern awoken? Wyverns and dragons are not the same thing, Wheatley. How dare you? Oh, is that that big underground spot that I vaguely remember? Okay, well, now I need to figure out how to get all the way over there? I found the ancient baths!